the offset. This is also another common bend you're going to use every day as an electrician. This is when you're running from one plane and you need to get to another. So your conduit's actually going to go, maybe come down and hit that second plane. You could also use it if you are going on a flat run and say the whole conduit system doesn't need to move over. You can just move them all over at the same time. So offsets consists of two separate bends. They're both going to be the same degrees, and the main measurement you're looking for is the distance between bends. Now, every degree has a different multiplier for your distance between bends. The most common degree we use is the 30 degree bend. Reason being is the distance between bends is always times 2. Makes it really easy if you are doing a 4-inch offset, the distance between bends is 8 inches. 5-inch offset, the distance between bends is 10 inches. Once you get into 10 degree bends, 45 degree bends, 60 degree bends, those variables change, they get closer. So for that, you just look up what the multiplier is, multiply your rise, and that's gonna be the distance between bends. So for this instance, I'm gonna do an offset based off of 30 degree bends so that I know my distance is gonna be twice what I want. So before I start any of my measurements and markings, I wanna decide what kind of offset am I doing. Am I doing a departing offset, or am I doing a landing offset? The difference in the two is, like we said before, I'm always moving in one direction with my conduit run. A departing offset would mean I'm going in this direction, and at some point maybe there's a ledge, and right after that ledge I want to move down a step. I know that I can't start my bending until that ledge ends. So I go, it's a departing. I want to make sure the measurement I'm concentrating and doing on first is my departing bend, and where it lands isn't necessarily as important. Now, a landing offset would be the opposite. I have a ledge up here and I'm coming this way. I know that I can't go too early and I'll have a big piece of pipe before the ledge. I can't go too late because I'm going to hit the ledge. I want to land right on that ledge. So that mark that I'm looking at is kind of what I'm most caring about. I don't really care how far back it leaves, as long as it lands where I want it to on that ledge. So for this instance, I'm gonna say I'm gonna be doing a landing offset. I'm gonna be doing a 5-inch step. So I'm running this way, I'm gonna go up, 5-inch step. So just like in 90s, I really care about where is my starting and where is that land need to happen. So let's say that landing point is at 36 inches. I'm gonna make my first mark at 36 inches. So I know I need to land there, so I can think about it and go, good, every bend that happens in this conduit needs to happen before that landing position. So if I'm doing a 5-inch rise, I know I need 10 inches between bends. So I'm going to go this direction, 10 inches, and make another mark. Now, one tip for this, as you see, I just made both marks on one side of the pipe. You'll notice later on in the video, as I'm doing my bend, at a certain point I need to flip it 180 degrees. If I leave both marks just like this, my second mark is going to be lost. I'm not going to be able to really see it. So one thing I'll do is on my second mark, I'll flip the conduit a full 180 degrees and make that second mark. Good. So I'm ready to go start bending. Now, offsets, when we're bending offsets, we actually don't do these on the ground, we do them up in the air. So I'm actually going to be holding my conduit bender like this, up in the air. I'm going to put my first bend in the bender and I'm going to line it up with the arrow. So one thing I'm double checking myself on is I'm going to look at at this and go, I'm doing a landing offset. I know that all bends and all curvatures in the conduit need to be before that landing point. So if my arrow is here, I know that the shoe being behind the arrow is correct. I know that my second bend is going to be correct. If I had my bender set up the opposite direction, I know I can't have a curve after the landing portion, so that's going to be incorrect. So I have it set up. I'm on the arrow. Now when bending an offset, there's a couple key components, just like doing 90. Balance and control is kind of the key to this thing. You want to make sure that, I see a lot of guys when they're trying to bend, this is sliding this way, they're doing a whole bunch of stuff, and it's not going to work out for you. So the main thing you want to do is you want to really have control of the bender and the pipe. A good way to do this is kind of set your foot up behind the bender to make sure that there's no way it can slide out. Also, you're using the pipe and you're using, you know, the pressure of just kind of lightly holding it down to make sure that it doesn't slip and slide in and out of the bender. So whenever I'm doing this, I'm kind of always keeping a down pressure on the conduit. That gives me full control and it will do what I need to do. So the second thing to think about when bending offsets is you do need to mimic the pressure. Just like when you did a 90 and you had your foot pressure and it's against the floor, that same principle applies when you're up in the air. It's just you don't have any backing here to keep it in the shoe. So to take care of that, you want to have as much pressure as possible as close to the shoe. You don't want to be back here trying to bend because it's not going to have a lot of pressure here. The whole conduit is just going to kind of bow. So when bending, I like to use my stomach right here. You know, whatever you got to do to keep as much weight going into that bender. So now I'm ready to make my first bend. I got it on the mark. I've decided I'm going to be using the 30 degree angle. So I'm looking to make the bottom plane of this conduit be parallel with that angle. Let me get my stomach involved and kind of get as close to the head as possible, putting pressure, and I'm going to make a bend. I'm going to get it pretty close, but obviously my line of sight up here is not quite doing it. I want to make sure I get on the proper plane. I want to be able to see my eyes. I can see this plane. I can see the 30 degree mark. I can tell right now I'm not close. So I'm going to give it a little more. I'm going to recheck. When bending conduit, I kind of find that, you know, being patient and doing it kind of step by step is going to save you a lot of time, especially in offsets. If you do too much of a bend, it's kind of difficult to be pulling it out and readjusting. So I'll keep this kind of slow and a little at a time. Great. I feel like my plane here is matching up with the line there, so I'm ready to do my second bend. So I'm ready for my second bend here. I'm actually going to keep the conduit in the bender. I'm not going to take it out. All I'm going to be doing is moving forward, getting to that second bend mark. And this is what I was talking about earlier. I'm going to flip it 180 degrees. So when I flip it, that second mark now appears. I can see it and line it up with the arrow. So before I start bending, I really want to make sure I got everything in line. Because if you have the two bends and they're not quite in line, one's going to be going that way, one's going to be going the other way. So to do this, I kind of like to sight down the pipe. And what I'm looking for is I'm looking for the lines of the bender, the line of the pipe here, the line of the pipe down there. They should all kind of come in to focus with each other to where you don't see anything going this way or that way. So it's real important that you kind of find that eyesight for yourself to kind of know, good, I'm lined up where I want to be, and I feel like I'm going to have a straight bend here. So I feel like I got it nice and in line. I'm going to do the same principle, use my stomach, a lot of pressure right here next to the shoe, and I'm going to match it up to 30 degrees. Get close, make adjustments. So to check that this is a proper offset, I'm going to use the same principle I did with 90s. I'm going to use my level. I'm going to check the ground level first. So on this, in my perspective, I have a left liner. and check this one. And this is a left liner as well. So now beyond that, I'm now going to actually check and make sure I have the rise I want. And it's going to be at 5 inches. So now I know this conduit is good to go. Pop up there and put it in place. But now let's talk about adjustments. So say the conduit is a little too much, a little too little. Lots of times, you know, if either of these degrees of bends are different, it's either going to be facing down a little, up a little. If it's a major concern, you're probably going to want to get it back in the bender and, you know, rework it. One thing with offsets is you can do slight adjustments by pulling or pushing up, but just like on 90s, you don't want to do it kind of too far here where you're more so bending other parts of the conduit, not just the bends themselves. So if I want to go down, I'm actually going to kind of grab in this middle area so that I'm just concentrating on unbending this just a little bit and putting pressure down. Stand on the pipe and kind of do little motions like that. Same with if you want to pull it up. You need to pull up, little deals like that. Make sure you're not doing a full on adjust the whole conduit as one, causing the whole thing to bow. And that's offsets.